Good morning all, I'm Dr. B.B. Rasifa, PG resident from Pushpagiri Institute of Medical Sciences and Research Center, Tiruvallur, Kerala. My discussion topic is relationship of optic nerve canal to the posterior paranasal sinuses on computer tomography in Indian population. So let us have a brief introduction. We all know that posterior ethmoid and the sphenoid sinuses constitute posterior paranasal sinuses. The optic nerve develops prior to the development of the paranasal sinuses, and hence it is responsible for congenital variations along the wall of the sinuses. The most common position of optic nerve canal with the sphenoid sinuses is the supralateral position. So these sinuses show varying degree of pneumatization. An extensive pneumatization of the sinus and bony dehiscence predisposes to the optic nerve injury. The posterior ethmoid cell, that is the Onodi cell, is of great surgical importance when the optic nerve is seen along its lateral wall and surrounds the nerve. Therefore, detailed knowledge of identification of the structures and relationship of the ONC with the posterior paranasal sinus is the roadmap for the preoperative evaluation of FES, which is the accepted technique for treatment of sinusitis, and hence to avoid unintentional complications of the optic nerve. Now, the aim of my study is to determine the patterns of relationship of optic nerve canal with the posterior paranasal sinuses in Indian population. Now, the method. It was a retrospective study. It was done on 100 individuals, that is 36 females and 64 males, using 128 slice multi-detector computer tomography, that is GE Optima. And it was done with a section thickness of 0.625 mm in a coronal section of bone window. And the study period was extending from June 2021 to September. All patients who underwent computer tomography of the paranasal sinus with multiplanar reformation were included in the study. And the exclusion criteria was for patients with history of trauma to the sinus and children below the age of 13 years. So a total of 200 ONC and their relationship with the posterior paranasal sinuses were evaluated. Bony dehiscence and dematization of the anterior cranial process were also evaluated separately. The types of optic nerve canal was classified based on modified Delano et al. Classification. And this Delano classification was modified in the study conducted by Itagi, where type 1 and 4 remained the same, but type 2 and 3 were classified based on the degree of projection into the sphenoid sinus. That is, if it is less than 50% projection, that is designated as type 2, and if it is more than 50%, it is designated as type 3. Now, type 1, where the canal is supralateral to the sphenoid sinus without indentation on the sinus wall, and type 2, when there is indentation on the sinus wall, which is a wall contour with the less than 50% protrusion of the nerve. And type 3, where the optic nerve is traversing through the sphenoid sinus with more than 50% protrusion of the nerve circumference into the sinus, and type 4, where the canal is adjacent to the sphenoid and the posterior ethmoid sinus, or the presence of Onodi cell, designated as type 4. Now, the result of my study came out as the most common ONC was the type 1, that is accounting for nearly 62%, followed by type 2 and 3. That is 15 and 13.5%, and least was type 4, that is 9.5%. And bony dehiscence was seen in 12% of the cases, and pneumatization of anterior cranial process in 11%. Bony dehiscence and pneumatization of the anterior cranial process were mostly seen in type 3. Now, this is a pictorial representation of the prevalence of the types of ONC. In this also, we can see that type 1 was the most common one, either in on right and left, nearly 62% as a total. and type 4 was the least one, that is 9.5%. And next, this is a block presentation of the same. And next is the prevalence of bony dehiscence and the pneumatization of the anterior glenoid process. In this we can see that out of the total types of ONC, the bony dehiscence was most common with type 3, that is accounting for nearly 59.3% of the cases. That is nearly, we have type 3, nearly 27 ONCs were identified. And pneumatization of the anterior glenoid process was also most common in type 3, nearly accounting for 48%. This is a block presentation of the same. So optic nerve injury is one of the most catastrophic complications of sinus surgeries. Hence, CT imaging prior to the surgery is an excellent modality, as it is not only demonstrate the bone, but also the air pockets and the soft tissue. Optic nerve is usually protected by the bony covering of the sphenoid breakaway. Excessive pneumatization with extension into the anterior and posterior glenoid process is another risk factor for complications during sinus surgeries. Increased pneumatization of the posterior ethmoidiacel, that is ONOD cell, forms the boundary of the ONC, causing optic nerve injuries during the FES procedure. So in our study, out of the 200 optic nerve canals evaluated, I've already discussed, we have 124, that is nearly 62% of the cases were type 1, and the least was type 4, 9.5%. As well as the prevalence was of bony dehiscence and pneumatization of the anterior glenoid process was most common in the type 3. So we can see this is the type 1. We can see the indentation of the optic nerve. Not indentation, just it is seen this adjacent to the sphenoid sinus on the right side. You can see the type 1. Next is type 2 with mild indentation, less than 50% indentation. And type 3 with this more than 50% involving the surrounding the nerve. And type 4 with bilateral ONOD cells. And you can see the pneumatization of the anterior glenoid process and bony dehiscence and thinning off. So to conclude, the relationship of optic nerve canal to the posterior paranasal sinus varies in different individuals, with type 1 being the most common. Type 2 and 3 with bony dehiscence and pneumatization of the anterior glenoid process, and type 4 tend to cause complications like optic nerve injuries during sinus surgeries. And surgeons being aware of this can avoid serious injuries to the optic nerve. So preoperative MDCT help radiologists to identify the type of ONC, and it is beneficial for the surgeons so as to prevent iatrogenic nerve injury during FES. Thank you.